Hello everyone and welcome back to Dark Souls.
We're finally back at the Painted World of Ariamis. I figured we should come here and do this before we fight Ornstein and Schmo, get this out of the way. And now that we're playing on the Switch version, we should have a little bit easier time because we're not on the 1.0 release where this area is bugged and 10 times harder. Because normally, it's challenging, but it's not ball-busting. Like it was when I tried to do this before. My balls were popping all over the place. Okay, I was about to say, why'd I go up there? That's why. God, I'm kind of extremely excited to finish this game just so I can move on to 2 and 3 and Elden Ring. As I said before, I'm gonna skip Bloodborne just because I currently don't have a way to play it. Well, I have a PS4, but it doesn't run well, so just in case anyone missed when I talked about that before. That's why I'm going to be skipping Bloodborne. When I get a PS5, I might go back and play that one. I don't know though. The tiny bit that I have played, I didn't really like, so I'll have to see if it's something I want to do or not. Something I really do want to do is I definitely want to go and play Demon's Souls. Which I have to keep reminding myself is not Demon Souls, it's Demon's Souls. Just a weird little eccentricity. Yeah, I'm not getting toxic here. You ain't doing that to me. That's not cool. I am excited to play Dark Souls 3. That's one I've never played before. I played, like, just the tutorial area, and that's it. Because it was on my Xbox One that I did not own for very long. I was never a huge Xbox One fan. Okay, let's open up that shortcut. And now to the dreaded wheel skeletons. This part could be what breaks us. I'll go over here. There's an item here. Is it a trap? It is! I knew it was a trap. Now when I do Dark Souls 2, I'm gonna have to make sure I do the original and the scholar version, because there are huge differences between the two versions. I'm also going to eventually come back and do the I'm also going to have to come back and do the PC version of the remaster for Dark Souls 1, because I've heard they made some changes there that people were not big fans of. And when I play a game like this and I form an opinion on the game, I want to play every version that's available so I can see the perspectives coming from people that might have played a different, better or worse version of the same game. Because who knows, maybe you played the Xbox 360 version so you got a bad impression because that game ran like actual garbage. But maybe you played the PC version, which you could mod to run well, or if you had a beast of a rig, it would run well, and you had a great time. It really depends. I have no idea how the PS3 version ran, because I've never played that one. All I can say is, for Dark Souls' original experience, your best bet is the Nintendo Switch version. Because the PC version is no longer available on Steam, and if you don't like the changes that the PC version of the remaster made, well, the Switch version is just the OG game, but in 1080p, still 30 FPS, I'm pretty sure. But at least it's stable 30. There we go. I knew there was an item in here we had to get. There's also a ladder over somewhere this direction. No, staircase. Ooh. Don't like you. Can you give me a pyromancy? Yeah, I don't know why I'd want that. I'm not playing a pyromancer. I should do a magic playthrough when I do the PC remaster. I've never played this game with sorcerers or faith, but I don't know. Maybe we'll see. So yeah, anyway, I'm going to be doing the original and the Scholar, the first-in version of Dark Souls 2. And then Dark Souls 3 does not have multiple versions, so yay. Ow. I'm probably not going to play Sekiro. I did play that one when it came out, and I did not like it at all. Completely different combat style, I get it, but not my thing. Alright, Priscilla, you're going down. I just found it funny that they just let you run right past that guy. Ow, why would it kick? I didn't. Oops. I didn't mean to do the kick. Ow, I did it again. I didn't want to kill this guy. I want to... Oh, you're still alive. I thought you had been dieted. Ow, stop kicking. Why do I keep doing that? I'm gonna have to make a little space because I don't trust that thin little gap. I'm gonna try to keep him on it as much as I can, though. Ow, you have a long reach. It's because you're using a sword. The other version of you I fought before was using a little short little mace. You did drop an item. Well, that was not worth it. Hello, Crossbreed Priscilla.
Who art thou? If thou hast misstepped into this world, if thou seekest I, thine desires shall be requited not. thou must returneth whence thou came. This land is peaceful, its inhabitants kind, but thou dost not belong. I beg of thee, plunge down from the plank and hurry home.
Can I have your scythe? Your scythe is so much cooler than mine. Well, I want to be full up on health, but, you know, business is business. Oh, you're a little bit further away than I thought.
I expected as much from thee. Why does he hurry toward thine death?
Alright, so she's invisible for the first half. You can't see her except for her little footsteps. Until you hit her up a little bit, and then she becomes visible. Ice is the only thing so far that's really hurt me. Sorry, but I want your scythe. Your soul. Also, twin humanities is nice. Also, these extra 30,000 souls are even nicer. Here's a little behind-the-scenes tidbit. This painted world of Ariamis was actually the first area of the game designed. It's also coincidentally an area I don't like at all. Oh, and it actually puts you right back in the room here. Okay. I might just homeward bone back. Oh no, it's gonna send me back to the painted world bonfire. I'm stupid. I am so dumb. Oh no, it's not. Never mind. I'm a genius! Some levels to two more, and we're at the soft cap for dexterity. Now the question is, does that work for any scythe? Do I have to send this scythe, or is there another scythe I can use? I'm assuming it doesn't really change my... Well, it said I could use a halberd or a whip, too. I could just ascend the halberd. Does it just turn it into that weapon itself, or does it upgrade it into the weapon? And I need to know that clear distinction, because if it upgrades it additively to the weapon, that means it would transfer the stats and affect that, but I don't think it would. Okay, I do need to get it to plus 10, though, before I can ascend it into that, supposedly, so. We got 10,000 souls to spare. We got a blacksmith right up here. Let's go see what we can do. No! Did not want to have to wait that entire cycle. Mr. Blacksmith, I'm sorry, I don't know your name, but I need your assistance in this endeavor. And it does say it has to be at this blacksmith specifically. It can't be at Andre or the skeleton blacksmith in the catacombs. Which is interesting. I also think it's interesting that there's a bunch of these guys right outside this blacksmith. Die here. I can already tell you that. Or not. I am a god. One problem down. You guys need to stop coordinating your attack so perfectly. Thank you. I didn't think you'd actually, do it. You also need to stop being just far enough away that I can't reach you. And somehow that hit both of them. I don't have any Titanite shards. It costs 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 to bring something to plus 5. Ooh, that's half of my souls. I'm not going to be able to get it to plus 10 right here. But let's go see if I can do any halberd, whip, or scythe. So let's do halberd. Must have miscounted it. Need one more. That's not what I wanted. Oh, I do want that. Hold on. Can't buy that. Not like I'm gonna use that all that much anyway. Should have enough to... Yeah. Now it's plus 5, I'll have to ascend it to get it to plus 10. That costs large Titanites. Or a Titanite chunk. Wasn't planning on looking at that. I wanted my halberd. Why can't I do my halberd? Oh, is it because I gave the thing to Andre? I gotta bring it to Andre to bring it up to plus 10? Okay, that can wait until after Ornstein and Schmo, though. So again, I don't know why I'm starting to walk. I don't want to walk all the way over there. Reinforce our own weapons. Oh, I can reinforce a shield too. Does that actually help anything? Stability, which affects the amount of stamina I lose when I get hit while I'm holding up the shield. So that's not terrible, but it only increases it by one. It doesn't increase the actual damage reduction at all, so. As per always in the Dark Souls series, there is absolutely zero purpose in upgrading your shield. Did I get an armor smith box? I think I just Jimmy Neutron brain blast had a thought. I have never upgraded my armor in Dark Souls 1. Looks like I can't even upgrade the set I'm wearing right now. These take twinkling? Of course they do, they're super heavy. Interesting. Never done that before. Either way, we should be able to kill Ornstein and Schmo right now. No problem. Probably a decent problem, but they are at least killable. We don't talk about my last attempt against them. That was not good. Interesting. Let us go kill Ornstein and Schmo. Can we all agree that the run back to this boss is terrible? Not because you're gonna get hit or possibly die trying to get back there, but just because it takes so long to run. Mr. Ornstein, can I have some more? Oh yeah, that's some damage. Don't think I don't see you, fatty. Oh, I thought I could trade the hit there. I'm over here. Why are you running away from me? can't capitalize on that. I can capitalize on that. See, I'm doing so much better. Can't let the fatty get up behind me like that. Top off my health, I got 20 flasks for a reason. Oh, I was holding that shield up. Why didn't that shield? Whatever. Didn't do a ton of damage. Ow, I thought we were gonna trade again. Oh, but I can shield that one. Heal. Alright, I'm sure you have other attacks. Jesus Christ. Maybe you don't have any other attacks. Get me out of here. Ornstein, separate. I'll take it. Phase two time. Oh no, your friend is dead. Time to crush him! You don't want to damage the one that you're not killing first at all because it's just a waste. They heal back to full health once this phase starts. Ow. Usually able to dodge that perfectly fine. I usually opt to... I know most people kill Smo first and then fight Super Ornstein. I prefer fighting Super Smo. I find his slow attacks a lot easier to avoid. Even if he does have a much higher health pool. Well, that's definitely gonna hit me while I'm in that corner. It's okay, we're fine. Ow, did his foot kick my shield before he dropped? It looked like his foot kicked my shield before he actually dropped down. I don't know why I'm sucking at dodging his attacks this time. Like, bruh. my god. I cannot believe that that was the attempt that worked. I was at the blacksmith and I was like, you know, this lightning upgrade, that might be nice to have. And then the second I walked into the arena, I was like, oh crap. They use lightning. So of course the attempt where I'm doing less damage because I have lightning is the one that wins. Of course it does. I also panically put my humanities there just in case I needed them to heal. I am not going to be making anything with that. Let us level up before we do anything else. Jesus.
Thou come hither, child.
I am here.
O chosen undead, I am Guinevere, daughter of Lord Gwyn and Queen of Sunlight. Since the day Father is formed in obscureth, I have awaited thee. I bequeath the Lord Vessel to thee.
Oh my god.
Succeed Lord Gwyn and inheriteth the fire of our world. Thou shalt endeth this eternal twilight and avert further undead.
The music is fitting for the scene, but it's not fitting for this game. I'll say that. Ugh, we got the Lord Vessel now, though. Everything gets so much easier. Unfortunately, there's only a couple set bonfires you can warp to. You can't just go to any bonfire in the game. Which sucks, but what are you gonna do? Thankfully, it looks like we got all the ones that we're going to need already to go to the second half of the game, which is, in my and most people's opinions, the worst part of the game. Hello, Frampt. Let me bring that Lord Vessel down. Yes, it was. I already know I talked to you originally. There we go. Please don't eat me. Please don't eat me. You ate me. You saw that. He ate me. He violated our contract. I will sue you, Frampt. That was gross.
This is the Firelink Chamber for the successor of Lord Gwyn. Now, place the Lord Vessel on the altar.
Never actually looked around here. I can't get to any of those side places, but it's kind of neat that they modeled this whole thing. I I'm so terrified. The first time I did this, I thought placing the Lord Vessel here would actually give up the ability to warp that I got from the Lord Vessel. That gets rid of the fog so we can actually go to those areas. Are any of them worth going to? No. But we're gonna do it anyway. Question is really, which one do we want to do first? I think I usually end up doing definitely not the Grave of Saints. I don't think I do the Duke's Archives first. I don't think I do the Four Kings first either. What's the other one? Oh, the Lost Isolith. I think I do that one first, just to get it out of the way, because I hate it so much. Alright, let's do it. Alright, we're not gonna need this bonfire again, so I'm going to do something crazy. Do it like this. Since I have no plans of ever coming back down here after I'm through with this area, now that I'm here and we're going through, we're not gonna need to warp back down to here. So we don't need her there. And she gives us a Firekeeper soul, so net positive. The only downside is we can't use it until we get back up. But we still have it. Thankfully, you don't need to go over there. Yes, that is 7 Taurus demons. Yes, Taurus demons. The boss. And hey, look at this. A Capra demon. Also, the boss. Yes, this is the worst case of reusing bosses as normal enemies in this entire game. sky is also so much harder when you don't have that staircase to help you. Just try to keep your distance and bait out his jumping attacks. That's also acceptable. As long as you're not taking too many hits, because he hits like a truck. And look at that, there's four more of them waiting for us. I love all the reused bosses in this game. No, actually what I do here is I don't even bother aggroing them, I just drop down here. Sure you get this nasty centipede, but it's not a big issue, because there's a bonfire right here. Ow, that I apparently can't activate until I kill it. Why are you hitting me through my shield? In that one. That was a little bit more annoying than I thought it would be. There's a bonfire here, though. This area is only scaled for 5 Estus flasks, which is fun. You spit fire, right? Yeah. To annoy me. Just like that centipede. And that Taurus demon. Because you're literally just there to guard the boss room. With our good old friend, the Asylum Demon. With a very delayed jump attack. A follow-up swing that hits you before you can stand back up. That was fun. Welcome to the second half of the game. What? I wasn't even close. I wasn't anywhere. Okay, first of all, I was not anywhere near close enough for you to get me with that grab that I didn't even see coming. Second of all, do you really need to do that much damage? Do ya? Are you sure about that? Do you really? I don't think you do. I think the benefits of this grass crest shield are finally being outclassed. I am going to swap it out for a better shield that I can't use.
34 strength, what the hell?
Never mind. Grass Crest Shield is the highest fire resistant shield I have. That I can use. Interesting. Dodge on the left side of him because you're always too close to the centipede. And watch out for his super delay. I forgot. He's just the stray demon with the stupid AoEs. But now he also does fire on top of that. That attack does not prune fire. I thought that attack would prune fire. That's actually very good for us. I don't even think any of his attacks do fire. I think he's just fire decorated. He's just another stray demon. I would appreciate it if you would cut out the AoEs a little bit. And as you can see, it is indeed a piss easy fight. And in fact, one of the dumbest fights in the game. I don't know why they copy-pasted the demon again. It wasn't fun the first two times. Well, it was alright the first time. It wasn't fun the second time. See, that might be a reason you want to keep her alive, but really, it's not that much further away than this tunnel. Which I will actually... buff this one. Let's just say I'm very happy in the future games they decided to tie your Estus Flask amount to your character and not to each individual bonfire. I really find this mechanic pretty annoying. Are you kidding me? I'm 95 souls away from leveling up. Oh, I forgot those guys don't drop souls unless you kill the maggots out of them. I'm 5 away. That is why you don't mess with the maggots unless you have to. Okay, now I have enough strength to use the other size, so I'm going to try that out. A similar damage, but it also, I'm pretty sure, yeah, 500 bleed versus 300 bleed, so almost double the bleed. Scythe born from the soul of Priscilla, the stark white crossbeak trapped inside the painted world of Ariamis. Even the gods feared Priscilla's life hunting ability, and in the hands of a mortal, its power will turn upon its wielder. Wait, this isn't gonna hurt me when I use it? Oh, it gives me bleed. Not as long range as the other scythe. Hmm. Might be pretty annoying in a boss fight. Is it every time I swing? No, it's only when I hit. More bleed, less range, but it also bleeds me. Interesting. Don't know how I feel about that. Either way, I'll keep using this one for now. It's still more damage, doesn't hurt me. Maybe if I increase my resistance. Maybe if you plan ahead for that and you increase your resistance to go along with it, it would be better. This is the way to continue. What does that one scale with? Is that still dexterity? I didn't want to equip, I wanted to look at the stats. Yeah. Still mainly dexterity. Oh, I see. I just see an item on the ledge here. Yes, I did. Ooh, I will take that happily. That branch is a trick. That's not gonna catch me. I'm not stupid. Actually, where do I go from here? Do I actually have to drop down onto the branch? Okay, that wasn't as far as it looked. No one's back here. There's got to be an item back here. Nope. Interesting. I'm holding off on healing because all of these 20 flasks are disposable now. If I don't have to use it, I shouldn't. Ew, what are you? Some contraption. I don't remember as much about the second half of the game. I've only beat the second half of the game twice, and I hated every second of it both times. Honestly, once you kill Ornstein and Smo, congratulation, you are winner. Must be some elevator up top there that I missed, so actually
feel like going all the way up those stairs, so I'm actually going to use a homeward bone just to get back up there. Just the little things. We're really pushing the time on this episode, so once I get to the next bonfire in this area, I'm going to wrap it. It's definitely not that side. Not that side either. Hmm. No, it's just an item past you guys. A good item. So, I'll have that. Camera, do not kill me. Ooh. Oh. There's downstairs. I don't know how I missed that. Okay, that explains it. Oh, hey, and here's the next bonfire. So next time we will be getting into the Lost Izalith. With that being said, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.